Hey everybody, welcome back to Mile a Minute Vlog. I'm Chris. Music can add so much to a movie. Now, I've always been a fan of music scores for movies and television. It wasn't until middle school that I really became a big fan of movie and television scores, or actually was introduced to it. Because I had just joined the band, I started playing an instrument that I really didn't understand. It's called a French horn. I mean, let's be honest, nobody's really ever heard of that instrument. But if you've heard a lot of classic movie scores, I'm sure you have heard it. And there are a lot of composers that actually use the sound of the French horn. One of them, for example, is John Williams. Now, I wanted to show you a little clip here to kind of show you an example of how music can add to the tension of and the exuberance of a moment in movies. Okay, so this first clip has no score on it, and it's from Jaws. Take a look.
Cooper, where are you?
Now let's add the score back in and take another look.
Hooper, where are you? Hooper, hurry it up now, tie it on. Hurry it up, he's coming straight for us. Don't screw it up now.
Don't wait for me.
Come on, Hooper, come on, hurry it up, tie it on.
Now. Kill it, quick.
It makes a world of difference, doesn't it? You can feel the tension as the shark's starting to swim by and they're trying to get that barrel attached. A film score can add so much more to something that's even normal or mundane, and that you wouldn't really recognize the emotion of it until that score was there behind it and subconsciously is pushing you one way or another. So I figured I'd give you some insight into some of my favorite film composers. By the way, I have grouped a compilation of some of my favorite tracks of theirs and put them on a Spotify playlist that you can listen to also. The link is right down here. You can just add that to your browser, go there, and give it a listen. First off is the man, the myth, the legend, John Williams. He has been writing music since the 1960s, and he's been doing it pretty well, too. He has written so many different film and television scores. I'm just going to let him scroll here beside me, but that's a lot. Wow. Okay, but we have him to thank for such movie scores and themes like the Indiana Jones theme. The original Christopher Reeve Superman theme. One of my favorites, Jurassic Park. Thank you. And Star Wars, he wrote the themes for Star Wars. He wrote all six movies. Could you imagine watching Star Wars and not having that fanfare blasting in your face right at the very beginning as those letters come up? He's even done music for E.T., Home Alone, Saving Private Ryan, Schindler's List, Jaws, like I had before. He is the grand master of music scores. Next up is Alan Silvestri. He's been around for a while also. He's the man that brought us this classic. Pretty awesome, huh? He brought us the Back to the Future theme. Alan Silvestri is more modernly known for the Forrest Gump soundtrack, but you nerds might recognize his work on The Avengers and Captain America. He's the creator behind The Avengers and the Captain America theme. You don't remember that? Here, give it a listen. See, makes you want to go maybe slow-mo walk down a hallway or go battle some aliens from a different dimension. Next up we have Danny Elfman, a composer that pretty much works exclusively with Tim Burton. He's done Nightmare Before Christmas, he's done Alice in Wonderland, he's done the Men in Black theme. He also recently did Sam Raimi's whole stint of Spider-Man before a different composer took over for Amazing Spider-Man. Now, he's also the composer behind the original Batman theme. Now, I'm not talking the Adam West Burt Ward version. I'm talking the Michael Keaton version. He also did the animated series version. There's many a time when I've gotten off work late and it's been foggy out and dark and I've popped the CD in and just driving to it. It makes you feel like you're Batman. Yeah, okay, enough geeking out. Next up is Hans Zimmer. He's got to be one of the hardest working composers currently working in the film industry. He brought us themes from Inception, from the new Sherlock Holmes series. He took over for the Pirates of the Caribbean franchise and basically took Klaus Badett's theme and just stretched it out and made it more epic and awesome. He's also done the music for Gladiator. He's also been called upon to do the new themes for two superheroes that already have classic themes by John Williams and Danny Elfman. He's the composer behind the Nolan Batman trilogy. He gave us this. You, but now when people think Batman, they hear that. They might not hear Danny Elfman, but they definitely hear that. He's also brought us the new theme for Superman. You're no longer really hearing the John Williams theme, even as epic as it is, and it will always be the Superman theme, but he brought us the Man of Steel theme. modern take on the Superman theme. It's awesome. Now expand into composers that work not just exclusively in film, but also in television and even in video games nowadays. The first one is Michael Giacchino. He pretty much exclusively works with J.J. Abrams, but he has done some work with Pixar. He's done the scores for The Incredibles, for Up. He's also the man behind one of my favorite themes from the TV show Lost. He also recently took over doing the Star Trek series when J.J. Abrams took over, and he kind of added his own little melody to the film. It's amazing that just a couple notes can make the hairs in the back of your neck stand up or give you goosebumps just from thinking about that. Also, we have Ramin Djawadi, who is really starting to make his way into a lot of films currently. He's done the Iron Man films. He's done Pacific Rim. He's done the music for Game of Thrones. He did the theme for Game of Thrones. Not only has he done Game of Thrones and the other couple movies that he started to do, but he's also been known to do a lot of video game scores. Well, I hope I was able to give you a little bit of insight into movie scores. Don't forget, you can check out a playlist of all these different composers right here at this link. It's a Spotify playlist, so it's free to listen to. Question of the day, I want to know, what is your favorite movie score? What is your favorite song from a movie? Put it in the comments below. Also, don't forget you can follow us on Twitter to get all your nerdy and geeky delights, and also to get updates of when we post videos. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. You can click on the thumbs up down there below, and that'll like this video. You can click on subscribe up there, and you'll basically subscribe to our channel. You'll get updates in your YouTube feed when new videos come out. For the Mild Mannered Vlog, I'm Chris. Hey, it's the holiday season. Don't forget, if you're looking for some gifts for your nerdy and geeky friends, you can click right over here. We have a video with a bunch of ideas. Go ahead, just click right there. Come on.